tried to speak more to the sort of the hidden hunger in even the most unlikely people for whatever the word God refers to. The place you're called to be is a place where your deep gladness and the world's deep need meet, both those things. So many people get into some line of work by chance. It's what their father did or their mother did or what seems to open up at the time and that it happens to pay the kind of money that they feel they need. To have to encourage young people to think seriously about what they really want to give their lives to before they sort of get into this pattern that's going to take them, heaven knows, 40 years. There was a wonderful novel by John Marquand, that forgotten American novelist, called A Point of No Return, I think, where a young man finally gets, all his life he has struggled to become president or vice president of the bank he works on. Finally he does it, he gets it, he makes it. He's given the office, he's given the salary, and he thinks, my God, I've spent my whole life trying to get to this point, and now that I've gotten it, I realize it's nothing that I want to do at all. So to get people to stop and think and consider whatever sort of ministry it is. One of the things that I think would appeal to young people about the ministry in whatever form, either in a church or as a writer or as a teacher, is that it's one of the few places where you were not only permitted but encouraged to speak with real honesty out of the depths of who you are. My first job was teaching at the same school I went to as a child, Lawrenceville, in prep school in New Jersey. And I left there in 1953 to become a full-time writer. I'd already written two novels, the first of which did extremely well, in fact did better than anything else I've written since, which is a depressing thing about. But nonetheless, I moved to New York to become a full-time writer. The place where I lived was right next to the Madison Avenue Presbyterian Church, which had as its minister in those days this marvelous man, George Arthur Buttrick, marvelous preacher. And he was talking about the temptation scene, the temptation of Christ, and how Satan takes him up to the top of the mountain and says, oh, you can be king of all of this if you'll simply kneel down and worship me. And Buttrick said, Jesus turned him down, he wouldn't do that. But he said, nonetheless, Jesus is crowned king again and again in the hearts of those who believe in him, amidst confession and tears and great laughter. And the phrase great laughter, it caught me so off guard, perhaps for other reasons. I just absolutely, it was in some ways, it really was the turning point of my life. Tears sprung from my eyes, and I knew I had to do something. The fund, I can't remember how it came into my life. I can't remember who told me about it. Somebody did, and it was just made to order for me because in those days it was aimed at people who had not yet made up their mind one way or the other, but who thought that it might be interesting to spend a year in a seminary just to find out more about what they might want to give their lives to doing, and that was exactly my position. I had been deeply moved by the sermon by Buttrick and by other things to think that maybe, despite all the reasons for finding it incongruous, maybe the ministry was for me. And one thing led to another, and I've interviews and letters and all that sort of thing. And finally, I went to Union Seminary, and that was the sort of pivotal moment of my youth. I wanted so much to know about things that I really didn't know much about at all, and was sitting at the feet of these absolutely marvelous teachers. So, my gratitude to the Rockefeller brothers is huge. I think without their fellowship, who knows what I might have done. Maybe I could have scraped the money together and gone anyway, but I went because they made it possible. I wouldn't give it up for anything because it led me into situations and led me into the lives of people. It led me into my own life as nothing else I can imagine doing would have done. If you're thinking about it, give it a try because you never know where it's going to take you. It was such a rich experience for me. I think it's wonderful that it still goes on.